I'm Niamh MacNally, and I'm a curator here at the National Gallery of Ireland, and I manage the prints and drawings study room of the gallery. I suppose from your point of view, you'd want to know mostly about one's background, and I would say, I've been working in the gallery for 16 years. Never thought I'd be here for that long. You know, you always think, anticipate you're going to be somewhere for 3 years, but the gallery is one of those places that kind of scoops you up, and you're always thinking ahead in terms of exhibitions and planning. So that 16 years has really flown by. But I suppose from where I started off, I would have liked the likes of art history or art. I was very good at art at school, and I was also very good at English. So I decided to study both English Lit and art history at UCD. So I did my BA and then followed that on with an MA in art history. And I suppose my first kind of point of entry into the gallery was the fact that for my thesis, I looked at the acquisitions policy of the National Gallery of Ireland, the Hugh Lane Gallery, and the Irish Museum of Modern Art. And that brought me into each of the institutions, and I basically interviewed a lot of the kind of key players within those institutions in relation to their acquisition policy. So it kind of gave me an idea about the workings of a museum or a gallery. Then after I finished my master's, I went to work abroad. I worked at the Cleveland Museum of Art for a couple of years. And that was a really amazing experience because I was dealing with a vast institution with a lot of money to be able to spend on acquisitions and programming, etc. And that gave me a window into looking at different departments within a museum or gallery. So I worked within the education department, I worked within the conservation department, I worked with the modern art curator there. So that gave me a kind of another kind of broad scope of what it was to work in a museum. Then after I finished at the Cleveland Museum of Art, I took an internship for international students at the Peggy Guggenheim Museum in Venice. I think it's probably underwater right now, but it was an amazing experience because that again gave me great knowledge or more in-depth knowledge in relation to a modern art collection. And dealing with the public and tourists and all of that type of thing, and what goes into making exhibitions, etc. So, as I said, I then came back to Ireland and I decided to do some further studies. So I did a postgrad in arts administration, again in UCD, and that gave me an interesting bit of knowledge about management and marketing and publicity and accounting and all of those things to do with, you know, if you were running a gallery or if you were working within an arts office and working with things like budgets again. So that was all kind of giving me further information about where I would potentially end up. Also, what else would I say? I entered, after I did that, I did some teaching at NCAD in art history to undergrad students, and that was very interesting because that gave me an interest in disseminating knowledge to others and engaging with students, etc. And I also did some tutorials at Trinity in their art history department. Following that, I interviewed for a post here at the gallery, which was a fellowship to be the assistant curator of the prints and drawings collection. And those fellowships come up, every once in a while. And thankfully that year, one was dedicated to the curatorial department. So I took that up and I, you know, was here for 2 years, then I was here for another year, then I was here for another 2 year contract, and then I was made permanent. So I would say that coming to the gallery, you know, it was made easier by the fact that I had my studies behind me and also I had some international experience as well. Then, as I said, I've been here in the gallery for 16 years, and it's amazing the kind of varied type of work that you do here. So I suppose from my point of view, for you to know what type of work a curator does is kind of most interest. Well, say for instance, this is me in the prints and drawing study room, and this is me with my former colleague who's a paper conservator, and we're discussing, you know, the treatment of a particular watercolor. And I would work very, very closely with the likes of the paper conservators in the preparation of works for exhibition. What looks good, what looks right, what frame should be on a work, and whether they will tell us whether works need to be treated or whether what needs to be done, etc. So we would work very, very closely with our conservators. I would also work alongside the photography department in terms of gathering all of the material from the prints and drawings collection specifically to be digitized, because all of our collection is starting to be digitized to go up online. So a much vaster array of people can access our collection. So what I would do is I not only give access in the prints and drawings room to researchers or scholars or somebody writing a book, or university groups, whether they be art history students, whether they be animation students or illustration students, from all different art colleges or universities. So it's kind of giving them first-hand access to an important collection of art. And the specific thing about a prints and drawings collection is the fact that, you know, all of them are works on paper, whether it be watercolors, pastels, drawings, sketchbooks. So they're more susceptible to the damaging effects of light. So hence, that's why we have in the gallery a specific print room, we call it, or a display area for these particular types of work, where we have this kind of controlled LED lighting system, which doesn't interfere with the artworks on display. And within that particular space, we house three exhibitions per year, because with any work on paper, you can show it for about 3 to 4 months, and then it has to go back into storage to kind of rest, as it were. So just looking at the list there, what a curator would do, there's obviously the care of the collection, looking after it, making sure, working alongside the conservators, it's properly housed and stored. We research the collection as well, so everything that we acquire has to be researched and catalogued properly, so all of that information can contribute to further knowledge about an artwork, or it can go up online. Acquisitions as well, we would very much have to keep aware of what's coming up at auction, and we would propose acquisitions that then are proposed at a curatorial meeting, everybody agrees, then we would draft up board notes for the director to then present to the board. Everything kind of has these, you know, several steps before things are officially acquired into the National Collection. So that's something we have to keep on top of, and certainly within prints and drawings, that's an area that we're acquiring a lot in. We also, it's an incredibly varied type of workspace in terms of you're dealing with lots of different queries from people from outside the gallery as well as within the gallery, because I would work with every single department in the gallery on particular exhibitions. And exhibitions, yes, they're kind of very much a key aspect of what we do in the curatorial department in terms of keeping things fresh for people, you know, looking at particular artists in a more in-depth way. So exhibitions are definitely a key focus with that. And then with exhibitions, of course, come catalogues. And of course, we're very much involved in the writing of catalogues, not just exhibition texts that need to engage the public, but also writing of catalogues. So more kind of, as I said, in-depth examination of particular artworks. And then also, we would have the aspect of working alongside our loans list. So lots of different institutions request loans from us, and we request loans from others for exhibitions, etc. So there's always that kind of exchange going on. And you know, with any work from the National Collection, you can't just let it off into the distance to travel on its own. You have to have a courier with it. So people from the curatorial department go and actually courier works abroad to different institutions to ensure the safety and security of the work when it travels. So there's that aspect of the job too. Oftentimes not very glamorous. So there's, say for instance, I would be involved very much in when an exhibition is being installed as well, how I want it presented, etc. And very much you have to be on the ground when exhibitions are being installed. So I would say there's a lot of deadlines in terms of the work that I do, and there's oftentimes a big push on when an exhibition is happening. Also, very much an aspect of my job is giving talks, and talks about the collection specifically, but we would give talks to the likes of yourselves, to the likes of university groups, to the likes of just the general public, to the likes of the friends of the gallery, who then support things like our exhibitions and our catalogues, and who we would do kind of patrons tours and that type of thing as well. So anytime an exhibition goes up, you have to do a lot of talks around a particular exhibition or show. The exhibition that I have on at the moment is upstairs. It's called Bauhaus 100, the print portfolios. And this is an exhibition that's a loan exhibition from Stuttgart. And it's an exhibition celebrating the founding of the Bauhaus 100 years ago. And I was interested to see, I snapped these pictures because costs actually took our posters and our brochures and was looking at a kind of a Bauhaus style range. So it's amazing where your signage or your exhibition material ends up. So as I said, that's a loan exhibition, so that's dealing then with another art institution abroad, so all of what that entails. Dealing with the curators there, dealing with our registrar's department as to how the works are best going to travel here, all of that type of thing we have multiple meetings about. Another exhibition that I've been involved with directly as the curator and administrator this year is the Zurich Portrait Prize, which is on upstairs. And you can see the winning portrait there by the photographer Enda Bow. And this is the type of really interesting exhibition that you're dealing with a huge amount of entries, a huge amount of administration to go with that, because you're not only dealing with those that have applied, you're dealing with their artworks, you're dealing with the long list of those people, then you have to get the short list, you're dealing with a set of judges. So again, to bring something like an exhibition like that to fruition, there's a huge amount of meetings go alongside that. So do go up and have a look at that upstairs. And this is just some of the kind of range of material then we as curators have to produce. So we have the likes of brochures, pamphlets. I would have edited the gallery guides, the essential guide and the highlights guide. And then we would have to work alongside our exhibitions team in order to get the right type of look for particular signage, etc. So you're constantly dealing with things like designers and trying to make what you're producing the most accessible as possible, but the most professional looking as possible. That's another exhibition that I did that looked specifically at a woman artist who was being kind of reassessed after a good number of years. So that was a very successful exhibition that incorporated a huge kind of gamut of her works, not only oils, but works on paper, her beautiful drawings, and also her sketchbooks. And again, that was an exhibition that threw up a lot of things, because then people started saying, well, I have a Margaret Clarke too, and would the gallery be interested if I gifted it? So you're dealing with the aftermath of exhibitions then as well, and how people then want to engage with the exhibition further, or engage with the gallery further. Another exhibition that I worked on, which was very interesting, it was an exhibition that I actually worked on specifically with Catherine. O'Donnell in the education department, and an amazing program for education was devised for this particular show, because we were looking at a Dutch 17th century artist who was one of the first kind of artists to depict animals in South America from Europe. And so we had a lot of fun playing with the likes of the signage for that particular show to engage a younger audience as well. And for that particular show, it was an interesting one because I engaged with the likes of the Natural History Museum, and they literally transported the taxidermy specimens of the animals that were on show in the on the walls, basically as drawings or in the paintings. They brought down the actual South American animals to the display. So that was a way of us collaborating with a sister institution just up the road with the Natural History Museum. And we got zoologists in to give talks, and we got kids in to connect up with kind of like, was it a leopard skull or a jaguar skull? And, you know, so it was a really dynamic kind of exhibition to work on. So the exhibition that I'm working on presently is the Turner exhibition. And so I've got to go and write labels for that now. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Niamh. That was fabulous.
What's your favorite exhibition you've worked on so far? Like any of the ones you showed us or any other ones you did that you've preferred?
Well, as you can see, the exhibitions that I've worked on, and I've worked on over 40, I've just shown you a very small little cross-section here, but and the most recent ones. I suppose from my perspective, it was really interesting to uncover the work of Margaret Clarke, who was the wife of Harry Clarke, who's the more has always been the more famous artist, but people really engaged with that show because it was looking at a woman artist and a very important or significant Irish woman artist. So it was a way of totally readdressing the balance with that particular show. So, and you know, I can see here in the audience that there's a lot of girls wanting to go into, you know, the arts. So, and that's a huge proportion of our audience are women and girls. So I, from my perspective, it's very important to show that back to them with the work of women artists.
Any more questions? Oh, one more. What's your favourite part of working as a curator in the gallery?
From my perspective, it's the possibility of doing interesting things that will be seen by a lot of people. You know, each one of our exhibitions, like I think, are average on about 60,000 people. And from across all age groups. So that for me is very kind of rewarding when you bring something together, but it's viewed by a lot of people. Another thing I would say about this type of work is the fact that it's incredibly varied. Every day is different. You know, I come in to a whole stream of emails, which are, some are weird, some are wonderful, but it's you have to answer each one and everything takes a different tack. And so you might plan one thing for your day and your day goes completely left of field because, you know, things are thrown up at you all the time. So from my perspective, it's the variety is the interesting thing as well.
Thank you. Okay, last question.
What is the largest exhibition that's ever come to the gallery?
The largest exhibition that's ever come to the gallery, I suppose it was our exhibition of a couple of years ago in 2017. It was our big Vermeer show because it was an exhibition that drew together 10 Vermeers. There are only 31 known in the world. So the fact that we were able to get 10 here at the National Gallery of Ireland, among other paintings by different Dutch 17th century artists, that was a hugely popular show that had was sold out, I think, a month before it closed. And, you know, all of our catalogues were sold out. And it was an exhibition that not only was shown here, but it was also shown in the Louvre in Paris, and it was shown in the National Gallery of art in Washington. So it was an exhibition that traveled. Yeah, that was definitely our big hit.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, Niamh. That was fabulous.